This is the last recorded voice message of Ninoy Aquino.
Hello, Dave? Yeah, I'm at the airport and I cannot leave America without saying goodbye to you and expressing to you my deepest gratitude.
Look, our prayers are always with you. And all I can say, you remember that the words from you and anything you want to is in your fingertips for me, okay?
Yeah.
There's no limit to what I will do for you if you need some help. But at this moment, we are praying for you that for your safety and success and freedom of the people, okay?
Okay. Del Prezi, I received the Arellana.
How wonderful.
And we enjoyed them.
Wonderful.
And tell her we love her.
Okay, my God. I just wish I was with you right there, you know, but I'm with you in spirit and in prayer.
Okay, now this is the latest thing that I can give you.
Yeah.
My source is Cardinal Sin.
Yes.
Number one, Marcos checked in at the kidney center.
Yes.
The expert went, saw him, they did the test, he flunked all tests, and the conclusion was if they operate on him, it would be fatal. So he went back to the palace. He's no longer responding to medication, and he will have to be hooked up to the dialysis machine now more often. How he will last with that machine on, I don't know. Apparently, they are now moving to put in Imelda in effective control.
Yeah.
And they are going to revamp the cabinet with Ong Pin, most probably emerging as prime minister and finance minister. Sanjin Kohwanko or Ver, defense minister.
Yeah.
Odi Corpus, possibly foreign minister. And maybe Ayala, Enrique, maybe agriculture minister, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a major shakeup. Marcos met with his generals and apparently said goodbye to them last Friday.
Yeah.
He was on television in Manila 24 hours ago,
right,
commenting on the boxing fight of Navarrete and Salvat to show the people that he's okay.
Right, right.
But it's a matter of time, so he wanted 3 weeks to collect his thoughts, write his memoir, complete his book, and most probably craft the final stages of his administration.
Mm-hmm.
He's a man now, terminal, he knows he's going, and that's the background that I'm coming in.
Well, I heard some of this yesterday.
Yes.
After came on TV, I got some reports that not, of course, as authoritative as yours, but pretty much the same, that something was wrong and they couldn't operate and so forth. At any rate, the thought that comes to mind is that this is good and bad. Good in that if he's going and he knows it, he might show some compassion for the country and treat your return with more pragmatic, thinking, I hope.
Yes.
And that's the good part. The bad part, maybe, is that the hardliners like there were bulldogs without any political savvy, who may think that the next in line, obviously, that people would look at your return very...
Well, there are two reports I received along that line.
There's not too much time, but that's what I'm worried about.
Well, if they pinpoint the plane I'm coming in, the rumor in Manila is that I'm taking the private jet of Enrique,
yes,
from Hong Kong.
Mm-hmm.
But all planes are being guarded, and they may close the airport on Sunday or turn back the plane if they will be able to pinpoint which one I'm coming in.
Yeah.
The third one, and this is the real easy, they have two guys stationed to knock me out of the airport. And they will try them for murder. They'll convict them, but they have assurances.
That's what you may think about that.
Yeah, those are the things that
yeah,
I've been alerted. So I don't know what options they will do now, but I am meeting with ASEAN leaders beginning Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Indonesia, Suharto might receive me. Malaysia is already firm, and Thailand, it's just about clear.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Japan has sent word that if Imelda is in place, Nakasone is willing to use his economic clout.
Oh, really? Huh?
Yeah. To tell Imelda that if you treat Aquino nicely, we can dialogue.
Oh, that's good news.
That's news I got from Japan.
That is damn good news.
Nabazone is willing to send a private envoy, a secret private envoy, with a personal letter, making a plea for me, if I am still alive and in prison, that if they will treat me gently and come up with some kind of an understanding, Japanese economic assistance will continue. Because they are very upset that if the woman takes over and there'll be chaos, you know, that'll be bad. Now, the ASEAN leaders, on the other hand, feel this way. ASEAN today is already one region. And any instability in one part of ASEAN will scare investors in the entire region.
Right.
That's why they're very, very uptight about the possibility of the chaos and instability in the Philippines with the Imelda.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the background of my conversation with them, that I am not going to upset the apple cart, but that we can harmonize our movement. Now, to what extent they will be able to mitigate the hardliners, I don't know. That's the cancer thing. If I survive Sunday and I get to prison and I'm there in a week's time, I can get the works going. I'm picking up a letter from Nur Miswari telling them that if the government will trust me as a negotiator, then they can start talking again. But they will not talk to anybody else.
It sounds to me like you have an awful lot of losses on your side.
Right. Those are the trump cards I'm bringing home, which of course can be negated if one character just blow me out.
If I
get into my prison, there's no doubt, 100%, I will be brought directly to prison. I may not even get a chance to talk to anybody there on the ground. But that's okay. As long as I'm alive and in prison, I can start using my trump card. I will try to hold out for a meeting with Marcos. Now that he's about to meet his maker, I am almost confident that I can talk to him and tell him something. Although the cardinal tells me that you think you can sell Marcos a bit of goods like return democracy to electoral processes, forget it. You're dreaming. He's no longer in that state. This is the cardinal's idea. I don't buy it because I don't think that a man who is about to die would be, you know, too hard-headed.
Well, I just an input or an opinion here. I hope you are right, but as far as I'm concerned, I think the cardinal is right. I think Marcos, not only because he doesn't want to, because that's a pandemic at the point of his dying, but I think he has just, he's so deep in there, he has no choice but to stay where he is and live things as they are. And certainly we hope that that's wrong, because of course we don't want that.
Okay. But goodbye, Steve.
One last question.
Yes.
Any indication from the U.S. side that there might be somewhat helpful or cooperative? Well,
no.
Absolutely nothing.
No indication, except that they're watching me.
Of course.
They're following all my steps.
Yeah.
But I'm still hopeful that sanity will prevail and they will know that eventually they'll have to come to talk. Because I don't think they're very happy with the woman running the show.
Right.
Okay, my love to present the children.
Okay, then.
Yes.
God be with you.
Thank you.
Minoy, huh?
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye.
Thank you.